Right, the last two races for me are the last two from Ludlow today. The first of these is the 3 mile handicap chase, nor 220 event. One is Crackled, Alex Cherry, two Richard Boreas, Martin Needham, three Timeline Vale, Graham Clutterbuck, four is Cairo, Stu Gray, five is Cirque, Martin Needham, six is Patricia's Brig, Stu Gray, and seven Misty Rain for Obi-Wan. Seven horses in the 3 mile handicap chase at Ludlow, and away they go, and quickly away Misty Rain for Obi-Wan has gone to the front to form a crackle on his inside, then the grey horse, that's Timeline Vale for Graham Clutterbuck with the Rico Bioris on that one's outside. The first of the Martin Needham horses, Cirque, is just behind that. Up on the inside is Cairo for Stu Gray, and behind that is Patricia's Brig also for Stu Gray. There's only five lengths first to last, as Misty Rain is clear from in second, Crackle, the black coloured horse crackled in second. A forward there, Martin Needham, Cirque has gone. So Cirque has gone, reduced into a six horse field, as Misty Rain jumps the next slowly from outwide Rico Boreas for Martin Needham. Then Crackled on the inside of Patricia's Brig, Timeline Vale, the grey horse in between horses. They pass the stands for the first time. The water jump again. The water jump is the last jump, which is not the case in reality. But nevertheless, Misty Rain has a very short run in here after that last jump. Is it really going to be an important jump if they close up? As Misty Rain leads from Rico Boreas in second. Crackled is on that one inside. Then the grey horse, Timeline Vale, is on the inside of Patricia's Brig. At the back of the field, Cairo for Stu Gray. Six horses left in this 3 mile chase as Misty Rain takes him along here at Ludlow from Rico Boreas in second for Martin Lee in those red colours with the yellow cap. The orange cap and orange sleeves on the inside of that is Crackle, the black horse in the field. The grey horse just behind that, Timeline Vale for Graham Clutterbuck, and the two Stu Gray horses at the back of the field, that's Cairo on the inside of Patricia's Brig. As the jumper next, and a very slow jump there by Rico Boreas, loses a few places, but Misty Rain still a comfortable lead, about five lengths clear of the grey horse Timeline Vale in second, who's on the outside of Crackled. Then Rico Boreas has some slow jumping, has pushed him back into fourth. Stu Gray's Patricia's Brig behind that, and at the back of the field is Cairo. Both those didn't actually jump it that well. It's still Misty Rain in front for Obi-Wan, who's clear from the grey horse Timeline Vale in second for Graham Clutterbuck. As they come to the next fence, jumps it well. Another faller there, faller Rico Boreas, jumping was sloppy most of the race, and then finally has parted with the jockey at that fence, at the ninth fence, and only five horses left now, both Martin Lee horses are out of it. Misty Rain takes him along from Timeline Vale in second for Graham Clutterbuck. Then comes Crackled for Wellings Cherry, followed by the two Stu Gray horses at the back of the field, Cairo, who's on the inside of stable companion Patricia's Brig. So Misty Rain in those yellow colours for Obi-Wan has about a five length advantage of Timeline Vale in second for Graham Clutterbuck. Then comes a Crackle for Alex Cherry, and the two horses at the back in the black colours for Stu Gray, Cairo, and Patricia's Brick. So Misty Rain, five lengths clear of Timeline Vale in seconds. They come to the next. Slow jump on Misty Rain, but all the horses behind him made mistakes as well. All of them were slow over that fence. So Misty Rain jumps that from Crackled in second of Timeline Vale, and that one's inside. Then comes Patricia's Brig and Cairo at the back of the field. With about 11 furlongs left to travel, they jump the next, which was an open ditch. And Misty Rain, about four lengths clear of Timeline Vale in second. Crackled is behind that. Then comes Patricia's Brig, who's ahead of stable companion Cairo at the back of the field. So they come to the water jump, which is the last jump, and actually the winning post is about a stride after that. So that water jump misplaced, it should be just after the winning line. But anyway, Misty Rain takes him along from Crackled in second. Then comes Patricia's Brig in third. Timeline Vale is on the inside of Patricia's Brig, and Cairo at the back of the field. But only about 5 minutes off this leader now, as Misty Rain has come back to his field. Misty Rain, just about two lengths clear of Crackled in second. Patricia's Brig has moved forward for Stu Gray. Crackled has moved up on the outside of Timeline Vale, who's dropped to last place. Timeline Vale, well, up in second not so long ago, has gone to the back of the field. But only 5 lengths off this leader, Misty Rain. So Obi-Wan's Misty Rain, with about less than a mile to go, comes to the neck, jumps it well from Crackled in second. Then gets Patricia's Brig, and made a slight mistake at that bench. Cairo is on the outside of Timeline Vale. There's 4 lengths from between the horses now, as Misty Rain has been joined by Crackled up front, and Alex Cherry's Crackle comes to the front. So it's a Crackle from Misty Rain. Then gets Patricia's Brig and Timeline Vale. Cairo at the back of the field. Timeline Vale reached for that and made a mistake at that fence, as stopped him. His momentum has crackled, has gone to the front for Patricia's Brig in second. It's crackled for Alex Cherry. Come to the open ditch and Crackle jumps it okay, but Patricia's Brig a better jump on the outside. And Stu Gray's Patricia's Brig has come to pick it up now from Crackle. Trying to rally up the inside is Misty Rain. Then comes Time and Vale for Graham Clutterbuck. His jumping hasn't been that great. And Cara at the back of the field. They've got four furs left to travel, and Crackle has got back up to the lead from Patricia's Brig on his outside. Then comes Cara, who's going well for Stu Gray out wide. There's only four lengths from first to last. Any one of these could still win. It's Crackle from Patricia's Brig out on the outside. Then comes Cara with Tom LaBelle, and that one's inside. And starting to struggle now is Misty Rain. It's Crackle in front for Alex Cherry from Patricia's Brig on the outside. Then comes Cara, for he's running on strongly for Stu Gray, and looks a big threat. They come to the next track. Cara jumps it well, so it's Crackle in front, and it's Crackle from Patricia's Brig. Cara out wide. Crackle, Patricia's Brig is coming up forward strongly on his outside. It's Crackle, then Patricia's Brig, and Cara. These three fighting it out. Cara up the inside, on the outside, but it's Crackle for Alex Cherry from Patricia's Brig. It's Crackle. He has the advantage with half a foot left to go. They come to the last, which is a water jump, but Patricia's Brig jumps it better. It's Patricia's Brig. It goes to the front from on the outside, Cara. So there wasn't the last. This is the last Patricia's Brig. And Crackle, it's Patricia's Brig. Who wins it from Cairo, then Ken Crackle. That actually was the last fence. Patricia's Brig wins it from Stable Companion Cairo. So Patricia's Brig wins for Stu Gray from Cairo in second. Also Stu Gray. Crackle's back in third for Alex Cherry. Graham Clavox, Tom Lavelle back in fourth, and the long-term leader, Misty Rain, the only end finisher, finished back in fifth for Obi-Wan.